for staying up that late. Thank you for staying up that late. As somebody said, I'm the only thing that's now between you and going to do something else for that. This is me. You'll find me on Schematic Unit Wiki. And you'll find me on Trophy Wiki. And I was the guy that did the Docker Fire talk yesterday. For Trophy Wiki's thing, I'm simply going back to what I've done in St. Louis, and some people will see some improvements. This is the awesome guy. This is the category data. This Mark Hirschberger is data in this case. This is also data. This is what you're looking for. This is what we did in St. Louis. We collected the list of attendees, and tomorrow you'll have the same list for this event. It's also data. That's why I collected all your photos. Next step from data is model. So this is a model. The good thing is that you can add it to the model directory. If you want more information about an attendee, you see there are already a few things. Just add a property and it'll be done. The model is extended. Somebody said you should not do that in a way. So this is a model. This is a meter model. That's in your wiki. If you want to change it, add a property. So if you want to, for instance, add cargo support, add a property, cargo support there, and your meter model will have cargo support for the topics. In fact, that's already there. It's invisible. So you've got the Trophy Wiki approach is having data model and meter model on your wiki, and you can simply change these things. Then you get nice things like help pages. Let's see your examples here. These are the kinds of results you would expect. To get these results, you won't, like we are, how do you say it? Lazy. I hate to work, so if I want to get this redone, I simply say, please, do this all again. This is what you learn from the page schema to regenerate all the pages. So this is 8 things I want to own. Categories, concepts, forms, helps, lists, Java code, whatnot. And now, since I have one topic, I get 8 things. I've got a customer that uses this system. And I got 13 topics, and we'll talk about one of these soon, because we want word files generated from one of these things. It's about the nurses. So that is called the Toys Club here. In English, that would be a nurse. I mean, one cities of the nurses. We'll see that in a minute. If I want to regenerate this, I hit this button. Off we go. 8 times 13. That's 104 things, which will be done in like 2 minutes. I'm not doing this now. I don't want to spoil my customer's web page. But this is a live web page for our magazine. So that's where we come from. And that was an update for those who have seen the conference talk I did in St. Louis. Well, let's go from there. Just 5 things, 12 slides. That's not far from getting home. The questions I'm going to answer is why should we combine Office and SMW? And what are the options? I'll show you an example. I'll show you how it works. I'm maybe going to ask you one or two. This is what you'll usually see in a project. People will organize their stuff around some file system and try to work together and put all their documents in there. Most of the documents will be Office stuff. I did a survey on that with software architects. And you know what? 23% use wikis, 30% use Confluence, and 75% use Office. So there's quite a bit to do to get them all to use things by wiki. So you have 2 problems. One problem is, how do I get my Office documents into the wiki? And how do I produce Office documents from wiki? So So for getting stuff into the wiki, I already had shown that in St. Louis, this would be your approach. So in the proper wiki, you've got Java as the tool of your choice. So you can use Apache. And Apache has a nice library, and their office formats are always with these nice names. So this is HWPF, it's known as the horrible word processing form. And there's your horrible something format, and your horrible step form. So if you want to do something with that, you need some JavaScript. And this is right in the wiki, it will actually be executed from there. And that's like, I'm doing some things which are no-no. Chris would tell us, oh, if I would put that on your wiki, they'd hit me. Don't do that, it's washed out on the wiki. And then there is a tutorial about how do I get something to my wiki. This is how you do it. This is a mixture of Java and it's called RISM. So it's got a simple for loop that says go through all my pages and get me the result in here. I think I've got my still open, so this is what we have as an input, just on the real estate data. And I want that in my wiki. So I push a button, which I'm not doing right now, and this is the result you get. It's here, so there. Basically, this is what the profi wiki can do, just like that. It gets nicer if you do more than that. I'm daring to do this if my VPN is running. This is now from the server that is running in the basement in Düsseldorf. I'm VPN connected and it builds the page. And this is another nice template. This time I'm going to gather the training material for my software architecture training. It's got 10 chapters, each chapter is a PowerPoint presentation. It's in two languages. And it's got about 350 pages each. So we're talking about 700 PowerPoint pages. And this is a 27-line script that will make a wiki page of it. Here you go. This is the result. So you get chapter 1 in English and in German with links. And the nice thing is I can click these things. I can say, OK, I want to have a look at that. So now it's transferring a few megabytes while live. And hopefully it will open this up. Yep, this is my Mac. This is the, what's that called? Ball. I'm not going to do that again. I'll stay in the wiki. As soon as I start some office or external tool, you'll have to go. And there you go. It opened up this thing. Please note this is not a copy. Original. That's important. That's what online file systems do. I can edit it, I can do something with it. This is done by something called client utilities. So a small utility is running on this laptop and supporting the wiki server and saying, okay, where is this thing? I want to open it. And then it does. The more interesting part is that I can look at my PowerPoint, pages, page per page, and see whether my translations are correct. For instance, here is something about a Turing machine. This was mentioned yesterday. So I got the page here. So let's look at that. There we go. This is the description of a Turing machine in my German slides. So I've got access to that. I've got to do this because if I was part of my office now, I'd have to wait a few minutes. I'd rather go to the PDF copy and go to the same page. No, I don't know which one. That's why I'm doing the PDF and the PDFs. So now this was all about getting documents into the wiki, and we've got some fully working wikis for that. We do advanced level requirements engineering at that time, and we've got this also those in there. We've got in software architecture we need for our participants. We've got quiz questions, like 500 quiz questions. We've got the whole syllabus with 112 learn items in there, and there's a cross-linking between quiz questions and learn items and stuff like that. So we make hierarchical things and tools and graphs from plain text documents. And we do that a lot because it makes learning much easier than going through pages and pages of documents. Now my VPN is down, so probably not hours for the recipe. This is the one that I was originally invited for. I'm only going to ask 30 minutes for. It's about the new semantic results format Word. It comes from the Second Life Care company, that's our customer. This company from Munich is interested in nurses, patients, and customers. So it might be that, for instance, a daughter is paying for her mother to be cared for by a nurse, so the daughter would be the customer, and the mom would be the patient. And there would be a nurse, and usually they take those from countries where you can get the support in a fashion that is affordable. So in our case, that would be like Slovenia, Romania, and Brazil, mostly supply nurses that do this job. But for this example, we entered some more known examples. So you might know these three. So your patient there is François Cuisy. He played Philippe in the Untouchables, so that's your patient. Or you've got a known nurse, that's Omar Sy, known as Gris in the real world, that would be Abdel. And we've got the customer, played by Florent Rodriguez. And you see the model which is behind this. You've got a nurse, a customer, a patient, and those are all persons. And this is what we got in the wiki. So mostly what they need here is the CV of the nurse. How can we get that now into Word? So there are different views on that. We've got the S&W view of things. You might want the Word file, you might want the PDF file of that, and there are different ways to get that. The interesting thing about this one is it doesn't make any difference to them. They see the same, and this is like three times the same thing. There are lots of trouble with that. And shortly discuss that. Because it's, are we talking the illusion or the real thing? Somebody already said that, right? We've got the bits, the pixels on the screen. And is that good enough for working with that? Or do we really need the data? And it was really hard to convince them to get the stuff into the wiki. They've been using that now for, I don't know, half a year. And they come from big exposure. 15 megabytes of Excel, 5,000 files on the disk. They were trying to move that around to Slovenia via a 500 kilobits internet line. Simply to work. So they now have the new system, but they keep uploading the CDs. Saying, oh, we got a PDF, that's good enough. But they want to do things like, is there a nurse that can drive a car? Is not older than 50 and does not swim. You're the guy who can answer that. I'm looking forward to that. And then they need to send these CDs. So that's where they would like to get a Word version of things. So what they do is they create CDs in Word format, right from the wiki. To do that, you need three things. You need a template, and this template has so-called needles. Did anybody of you use the PHP Office extension so far? Not. That's a feature of PHP Office. I didn't even know that until I found out that Martin Babbage, who programmed the package originally, had used that for creating CDs. He was doing PDFs in Word, and I was going, how did he do that? And it was just a few lines of code. He was using a Word template that was needles, just using the PHP Office extension, and then creating a Word file somehow. And then I found out that our PHP, our semantic result form of Haskell, actually uses the same technology. So I thought, wow, that the word version is this, should be simple. So let's see how that lands. Here you can look for the word format. As you can see, this is a proposed format. It's an open issue. Jerome had a look at the alpha code yesterday. He's not too happy with it yet. He doesn't want to merge it yet, but we're working on testing it better. And one of the issues will be, is there anybody out there who wants it? So if you want it, raise your hand, put it on the discussion panel page. Just put a comment on the issue there. That will promote the thing. And for me, it's just getting these tests done. And here should be our example. Other words, you start with a simple query. This is probably what we've done, or some people who have not worked with semantic data before should know you have an ask query. If you do that, you can query some information and you get a table of output as a default. This is how you get CV information. The next step would be that you could do it like in a template-based fashion. This was the first approach we took. You create a new template, and then you program your template, and they are your code result. That's Word, and it's in the wiki, and it's hard to print, and you can already send it by email. This is not what they want. It looks right, so you've got this illusion problem. Oh yeah, that's what we want, but how can we send this now to a customer as a Word file? And we don't want PDF, because we also want the version of the Zap logo, because we also our brokers for others, so sometimes our nurses work for other companies and then all over has to go away and the logo of another company has to go into the city. So we need multiple versions. So using the semantic error format, this is the magic. This is simply say format equals work. And then you submit if you will look up do I have an installation of that and then this will be useful. Won't work on your wiki, but you can download the GitHub from my and try it out. Then you need to say what should the filename be. You need to say what is my template, and then you can download it. And I'll simply do that. Right? And there you go, you can look for Word. If I click OK, and guess what? Word starting, and it will take a few seconds because Word is always so slow. Probably it's better to show you the one that has already been there. Yeah, this is what you get again. I hate Microsoft products. Turn over. I have to support that anyway because customers need it. No, my VPN is totally broken, but that won't matter because this is an horrible computer. And I think you're one or two slides away from this being finished. And from Word showing the real estate. What you can see in the meantime is the template, because that's what we heard. If you look at these needles, this is basically where all the stuff gets filled in, like your email address, your birth date, your religion, smoking or not smoking, the age of the person, and stuff like that. I just need to go back to my Firefox. stuff that didn't work in the past. So you have here some solutions for Microsoft Word that didn't work. These two are available. You got the ASO result format, which is there. The Word result format is in the Words.
Does it, I didn't see it, does it copy the, or preserve formatting that you have in Word?
If we do that, yes.
Okay.
I didn't program add anything special on that. I tried it out and said, okay, I've got X to all the elements, and now it would be a matter of fiddling with that.
Small matter of programming.
Somebody else, if somebody is interested in that, call me, you can improve that and make it a nice thing. The options are there. It's not working out of the box and making it complete as you'd see in like Confluence, I think, does a lot of that. And, or WordPress does a lot of that. And nobody's been working on that as a W yet. But it's possible with these options.
The external data extension, I think you can import CSV files, or I'm sure it can. Would it be possible to add this feature to the external data so that you can go to Excel now and then with the external data well, do what you are doing?
No. Mm-hmm. That's a major difference in that because the approach on the ProfiWiki approach text is get rid of all the limitations. This was the term complete argument. I don't want to fiddle with PHP or MapReduce or whatever there is in limitations. I got fed up with that pretty quickly and said, no, what's that? It's all limited and you don't have the full capabilities. So I opted for doing Java and say, I'm going to externally change the pages as I wish with some Java code and I've got all capabilities. And there are basically only two things that I would have constrained as feddable, as free, PHP, C sharp, Java. Those are the three top languages known in the world. And if you go with anything else like Ruby, Scala, Lua, anything strange thing, you will have a hard time finding people who know that language. And that will major on the method for doing it this way.
What type of data
do
you get out of the documents? I see that a lot of very structured looking data into the documents.
Looking at the PDF. It's very tedious, it's tough. cause for the messy and you won't like it, because the PDF is non-structured in the way you did it. It's only to explain stuff, but there is, are some possibilities to do that, it's not nice, but still this, if you have lots of data to work on, because it's better than doing it by hand. That is an idea that I'd like to pursue to make it more usable.